So in my last video, we have discussed about single area OSPF. In single area OSPF, we have done the routing part of OSPF with same process ID as well as different process ID. And also we have discussed about so many things like OSPF is link state, metric value, AD value. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about multi-area OSPF. My syntax will remain same, but we should have to discuss so many new things. So let's start with OSPF, multi-area OSPF. So in multi-area OSPF, I just want to let you know, practical remains same. But in multi-area OSPF concept is, multi-area OSPF, the concept is, if you want to connect two different off-backbone areas, like I told you, we have two types of area, area 0 and area 1 to 4.2 billion, okay, multi-area OSPF. If you want to connect, like this is area number one and this is area number two, then directly you are not able to connect router from area number one to area number two. The rule should be that if you want to connect area number one with area number two, then you should have in between area zero. So if you want to connect area one with area two, then in between there should be area zero. That's why this area is known as backbone area. Okay. So let me start with one design, our Cisco packet tracer. Okay. So I'm going to open Cisco packet tracer. Just wait. Where is Cisco packet tracer? Oh, sorry. This is Cisco Packet Tracer student version. I want to use this. Just wait for opening my packet tracer. Where is packet tracer? Here it is. So here is my Cisco packet tracer. Now, for example, you are making any design and you can choose any router, like any router 2911, 1841, it's up to you. For example, you have one network here and one network there. Okay. You have connected two PC here, two PC there with 9960 switch. And also, you are getting connection from this router, and this is getting connection from this router. Now, I told you, you can choose fast Ethernet cable as well as serial cable. So I'm going to choose fast Ethernet cable, like gigaport I want to use. But I just let you know that this is your area number one and this is your area number two. Like when I'm going to configure OSPF, I will configure this area as area one and this area as area two. So if I am connecting, this cable is with this. So I have to use that cable in area zero. Otherwise, area one is not able to ping with area two. For example, I'm using one more router there. Okay. So you want to use serial cable, so you can switch off this and you can put this. Okay. It's up to you. So I'm using serial as well as I'm using fast Ethernet. So it's your choice. You want to do practical with which cable? So I'm using like this. Okay. So if I'm using area zero from here to complete PC, and I'm using area 2 from here to complete pieces, this topology will not able to ping with each other, because the rule is if you want to connect two off backbone area 1 and area 2 with each other, you have to use like area 0 in between them. If you are not using area 0 between them, you are not able to ping with each other. Okay, so this is the concept. Now, for example, this is an area 0. We have to start with another theory concept. If any router is only the member of area 0 or minimum member of area 0, that router named as backbone router. This is the theory part. Okay. And now it is the area 0 part. So it should be backbone router. But these routers, like router number this and this, I'm going to do some color on this, like the blue router and this blue router. Okay. So I'm going for green color for backbone router. So this is your backbone router because it is the member of area 0. But both the blue routers are the member of area 0 as well as area 1. Because if I'm going for IP addressing like 10.0.0.0/29, this is 20.0.0.0/29. So here I'm going to use 30.0.0.0/30. Here I'm going to use 40.0.0.0/30, 60.0.0.0/30, and 70.0.0.0/30. So according to my design on this router, 60 should be a part of area 0 and 30 should be a part of area 1. So if any router is configured with two areas, then that router renamed as area border router. Area border router. Okay, so this is area border router. And this is also area border because this router contains with two areas. Now, this router is neither with area 0 nor with two areas. So we are not saying it as backbone router or area border router. Simply these two routers are known as internal routers. Normally these two routers are internal router because these are the member of off backbone areas. So this is internal router. Understand the concept. If any router belongs to 1 to 4.2 billion, then this is called internal router. If any router belongs to two areas, then it is for area border router. If router belongs to only area 0, then it is called backbone router. So we have to configure this and we have to check the multi-area concept in this. Okay, so let's start with configuration, like IP addressing 10.0.0.1. 255.255.255.248.10.0.0.3 I'm going to use as a gateway. So 10.0.0.2 and 10.0.0.3. So IP addressing is done. So after IP addressing, going to configure routers, enable configuration, interface gig 0 by 1, IP address 10.0.0.3.248. Now IP addressing is cakewalk for you. 30.0.0.1. No shutdown. So IP addressing of router number 1 is done. Now move on to router number 2. Interface gig 0 by 0. 30.0.0.2. no shutdown, and interface serial 000 is 60001. So just remember the rule. First make design, after that make IP addressing, after that routing. Because that is easy to troubleshoot the network, okay? Interface serial 000, backbone router I'm going to configure. 002 and serial 001. I'm doing it a little bit fast because already you know how to give an IP addressing, okay? So IP addressing video I have already shared so many times. But routing I will do like a little bit slow for your easily understanding. Now interface serial 000, IP address 70002. And interface gig 0x0, IP address 40001255255252. Exit. And on this router, gig 0x0, 40000, gig 0x0, IP address 40002. Now you can choose IP address according to you. That there is no like any problem to choose any like A class, B class, and C class. Okay. It's only your call, like which IP address you want to use. So IP addressing is done. Okay. Now it's time to configure multi-area OSPF on router. So start from my first router. Click on this. Do show IP route. Now we have 10 and 30. Now you can check there is a connector network. L stands for local. If you are choosing 2911 router, it show you the IP address. It show you your IP address, but with slash 32. Okay. So it's your IP address. So don't confuse in this. So we have to configure this with router OSPF 1. Any router like OSP 1, 2, 3, network 10000, 0007, and area number 1, because I have already chosen it, area 1. Similarly, network 30000, 0003, area 1. So this is your configuration. Sorry. Now move on to ABR router. Do show IP route. 30 is the member of network 30 is the member of area number 1, but 60 is the member of area number 0 because 60 is in this area. Now we have already defined the area. Okay, 60 is in this area. Now move on to another router. Do show IP route 60 and 70. Now both 60 and 70 are the member of backbone area. Network 60000003, area 0, and 70 also. Do show history. This one. Now they both are the member. Now on this router, 40 and 70 are there. This is also area border router. Router OSPF 1, 40000003, area 2. Just dragging it. And 70000003, area 0, backbone area. So this is a ABR router. So if any interviewer asks from you any question, like for example, I'm using area 1 and area 0 on same router. So what is this router? So you have to say this is area border router. Border router. Do show IP route. Now 20 and 40. But both the 20 and 40 are the member of area 2. Router OSPF 1 network 20.0.0.0.0.0.7 area 2. Network 40.0.0.0.0.0.3 area 2. So my whole configuration is done. Now, what is the difference between single area OSPF and multi area OSPF? First, I want to check the pinging. First packet is failed, and after that packet should be successful. So this is your successful router. Okay. Now, we have to check the difference. Now the difference is show IP root. You have to use command do show IP root. Now you are using show IP root. Now in my previous video, when I have configured single area OSPF, you had checked O was there. O stands for OSPF. But in this video, you can check IA code with this IA. IA meaning is OSPF inter area. Like this is the root 20, 40, 60 and 70 are coming from outsider area. What is the meaning of this outsider area? Wait, I will show you. Now area 1 has only two roots, 10 and 30. 60, 70, 40 and 20 are coming from area 0 and 2. So that's why it is renamed as multi-area OSPF, because it is coming from inter-area. But if you check roots here, do show IP root. Now you will check only 20 and 40. 20 and 40 is coming with IA, but 70 and 10 is configured with O. Why they are coming with O and why they are coming with OIA? So here is the answer. Because this is the router is in both area. Area 1 is its own area, area 0 its own area. So this is the router. When 10 root is coming to there, so it is saying it is from my area, so it is showing with O. Coming from my own area. Also 70 is coming on this router. So this is also O, but area 1 and area 0 had O roots. But if any root 20 and 40 is coming, then that should be come from IA, inter area. So if root is coming from my own area, then it is showing with O. If root is coming from another area, then it is showing with OIA. So this is the concept of multi-area OSPF. Like for example, in your company, you are like looking the roots for OSPF. So you have to check the roots. If roots are coming from OIA, then it is from another area. If you want to check your own roots only, then you have to check that should be with O. So differentiate this, we have changed the codes. So this is the concept of multi-area OSPF. So now you have already done with OSPF and multi-area OSPF. So one thing you have to discuss that we have solved the example with this, that area 0 is the backbone area. Any of backbone area wants to connect with each other, they should have to contact area 0 first. And in OSPF, we have to use this type hierarchical structure. Why? Because in hierarchical structure, the troubleshooting is very easy. Okay, so you have to implement this on your Cisco packet tracer. If you feel any doubt, then you can talk to me. Thank you so much.